My mother's had breast cancer twice. My sister's had it once. So I just assumed eventually it would be my turn. So I stayed vigilant with my mammograms and hoped for the best, which I really got the first time, which was early detection. Stage one, and I was very, very fortunate. There was no lymph node involvement. I had a wonderful surgery, followed up by tamoxifen, and thought I was finished. It wasn't surprising to me that it was happening at all. I'd seen my mom go through it twice and was a survivor and doing great. My sister had gone through it once and she was a survivor and doing great. So I really wasn't terribly concerned, just a question of learning what the next step would be and where I would want to do it. I continued getting mammograms every year. About year four, I went in for my routine mammogram and I got the phone call again saying they saw something suspicious. I had the exact same breast cancer in the exact same breast, even though I'd had bilateral mastectomy. The next step was they wanted to do a PET scan to make sure that it hadn't spread anywhere. There was a suspicious spot on my left iliac bone. That, in fact, was the identical breast cancer, which had now metastasized to my iliac bone. Went in to meet with my oncologist, who then told me about a brand new clinical trial that had recently started for a drug that was for this exact type of breast cancer, which is estrogen and receptor positive breast cancer. I was actually quite excited about this option, thinking when I got the second diagnosis, for sure I was gonna have radiation and chemotherapy and all that that would entail. So excitedly, I was offered this opportunity and was able to take advantage of it. It was explained to me that if anything ever showed up on a scan, that I simply would withdraw from the clinical trial and receive whatever treatment I needed. So I didn't see a downside, but I saw a great upside because the drug had been shown to potentially have no side effects except for it damaged your white blood count temporarily. After discussion with my family and careful reading, decided to go ahead and enter the stage one clinical trial for what became known as palbociclib. And I take my drug for 3 weeks. Then I'm off of the palbociclib for 1 week to allow my white blood count to recover. The letrozole you simply take once a day for the rest of your life. There was no downside to participating. And in fact, there was a huge upside because the standard of care treatment at the time was pretty unpleasant, along with some pretty debilitating side effects. Quality of my life is extraordinary. I don't think that if you saw me walking down the street, you would ever imagine that I was a stage four cancer patient. If no one ever mentions a clinical trial to you, you should ask about it. They exist all over the country, and there could be something that's available to you that you might not know about, but the doctor might. I would suggest also that it's critical that you work with doctors that encourage your participation. And lastly, I can't say enough about the importance of mammograms and early detection, because it truly saved my life twice. Without the clinical trial, none of the drugs and treatments that have ever come to market to treat cancer or any other disease would have ever occurred. They are an integral part of trying to treat or cure the illnesses that many of us are facing. One of the reasons why I choose to talk about my cancer and not sort of make it private, because I think it's critically important for women to know that you can actually go through stage four breast cancer and come out the other end. It's been 5.5 years, there's no evidence of cancer, and all I do is take a pill and live my life. Stage four cancer used to mean get your affairs in order, and it does not mean that anymore.